Hey, thanks for joining us. And for those of you watching us on YouTube and on Facebook, glad you could join us today. We begin with the latest on the upcoming elections. The late dictator's son, Ferdinand Marcos Jr., again topping Pulse Asia's latest presidential preference survey. Marcos was chosen by 60% of the respondents. The survey was held from January 19 to 24. A distant second, Vice President Lenny Robredo with 16%. Senator Manny Pacquiao and Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno Dumagoso tied at third with 8%, while 4% of the respondents preferred Senator Panfilo Lacson. Marcos's running mate, presidential daughter, and Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio also topping the vice presidential poll with 50%. In second place is Senate President Vicente Soto III with 29%, followed by Senator Francis Kiko Pangilinan with 11% and Dr. Willie Ong at 5%. Marcos Jr. skipping another presidential debate hosted by CNN Philippines, citing a conflict in schedule, but he is expected to attend a separate debate organized by a media entity headed by religious leader Apollo Quiboloy, who is facing sex trafficking charges, among others, in the U.S. Our very own Jackie Manaba now joins us with details. Jackie, over to you.
Kanina, while presidential bet Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. continues to build up his survey numbers and remains to be the front runner, he skips another major presidential forum initiated by CNN Philippines, a television network that is scheduled on the 27th. This will be the third major presidential debate that he will not be joining. Marcos Jr. skipped a television network's presidential interview in January, calling the interview and host bias. He also skipped the Kapisanan ng mga Broadcaster ng Pilipinas, or KBP-initiated forum recently, although he attended some presidential one-on-one interviews. Presidential bet Bongbong Marcos is expected to attend a presidential forum organized by media entity SMNI tomorrow, February 15. The network's chairman and founder is controversial religious leader Apollo Quiboloy, who is officially declared by FBI as a wanted suspected sex trafficker in the United States. Marcos Camp spokesperson Vic Rodriguez, in recent interviews, explained that they would shun debates or forums that pit candidates against each other. They prefer one-on-one interviews where the candidates could extensively and exhaustively explain his or her stand on issues. Rodriguez also added that they would review first the format of the forum before they agree to join. Now, political analysts have commented that this controlled narrative strategy of Marcos Jr. has helped boost their popularity so far. The camps of other presidential candidates criticized Marcos's non-attendance in the fora. Carmina, today, February 14, Marcos Jr. is in Cagayan with birthday celebrant and former Senator Juan Ponce Enrile. And Enrile endorsed the candidacy of Marcos Jr. before a crowd of supporters in his bailiwick in the north. Enrile was defense minister of late dictator Ferdinand Sr. before withdrawing his support and participating in EDSA revolution that saw the strongman's ouster. But in 2018, Enrile said millennials were misinformed about martial law and have supported Marcos Jr.'s candidacy in the 2016 elections too. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, Jackie Manaba, there joining us on the line. Take care, Jackie. Keep safe. And moving on with the news this noon, political analysts believe Marcos's unity platform has proven effective in pushing him to the top of pre-election surveys. But Cleve Arguelles notes Marcos is also benefiting from social media propaganda, which targets groups who are vulnerable to disinformation. He also warns skipping presidential forums and debates could be harmful for Marcos's presidential bid.
Voters will really start, getting disappointed that, you know, the front runner, the debate front runner, the survey front runner isn't really appearing in interviews and debates so much, right? It's only a matter of time before voters would start demanding that, you know, we want to see you talk, we want to see you respond to these different questions.
Well, at this point, we'll be joined by the spokesperson of Ferdinand Marcos Jr., Attorney Vic Rodriguez. Attorney Rodriguez, nice to see you again. Thanks for joining us today.
Hi, Carmina. Good afternoon and happy Valentine's Day to you and to all.
Same to you. All right. Now, I want to first get your reaction. Well, you have already reacted to the recent survey results. Your candidate continues to dominate surveys. In your reaction, you said that the numbers don't lie, that it is humbling, that the message of national unity is resonating. But what about the platform of governance, Attorney Rodriguez? Let's talk about that. What exactly are his plans for the country? And how is this message of national unity really going to deliver what he thinks is a what the country needs?
Like what I have said before, Carmina, we would rather keep our direct communication with the people. And during the sorties all over the country, it is that opportunity where Bongbong Marcos speaks of his platform to directly to the people. He talks about the foreign policy, his views on the economy, the pandemic response, and how he proposes solution on how we can get out of this pandemic economy that we are all beset with now. So nandoon pa rin kami na yung aming preference na direct communication with the people.
Mm-hmm. But wouldn't engaging in interviews, although challenging interviews, wouldn't that also communicate that message?
Precisely, Carmina. That is why we have submitted to that DZRH Presidential Forum. That is why we have submitted to the DZBGMA7 Presidential Forum. That is why there was this interview with Boyabunda. And that is why there was this interview with Corina Sanchez. So, importante sa amin yung mga yan. And tomorrow, we will go on live, doon sa live debate, sponsored by SMNI. So, not doon, we go out, nagpapasuri si presidential candidate Bongbong Marcos. At doon niya, ilinalahad yung kanyang mga platforma at doon din niya muli inuulit yung kanyang unifying and visionary leadership which he is offering to the country.
But what about the others, including this network, who have sent you invitations for interviews with your candidate?
We have granted interviews in the past, Carmina. It just so happened that lately, from where I sit, Carmina, we are, I think, 21 days behind our schedule. And that is essentially a problem. Where do you put the 21-day schedule into the less than, I think, 83 days left for the official campaign period? So medyo struggle, medyo problematic yung scheduling. So we're trying to maximize yung remaining official days to campaign and try to squeeze in all those scheduled sorties that were postponed because we were hit by COVID, all of our staff, and that comprises 21 days.
I can almost hear the other side saying, Attorney Rodriguez, that maybe you should consider working 18-hour days. That campaign, that viral campaign, as some would say, sort of backfired on your campaign. What are your thoughts regarding that?
What campaign? What 18-hour campaign?
That they were the sister of your candidate, Ferdinand Marcos Jr.
Well, I think you're not the right person to respond to that, Carmina. We have our own campaign to run, and we have an election to win, and we will shun any negativity, Carmina.
So do we take that to mean that this was done without your knowledge, Attorney Rodriguez?
I am not the person to be asked on that, Carmina. Go direct to the source, not to me.
Attorney Rodriguez, why do you think your candidate, Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., continues to dominate the surveys, even without participating in debates, even choosing what some people are saying, friendly interviews instead of challenging ones?
I don't think the DZBB interview was friendly, Carmina. I don't think the DZRH interview was either friendly, Carmina. So I don't know where you're getting your assumption that these are all friendly interviews.
The reason
why the people are continue to support him is because pagod na nga ang tao sa awayan, pagod na ang tao sa bangayan. Mas gusto nila mapakinggan ano ba yung ino-offer mo sa bansa? Ano ba yung proposed solution mo? Mas gustong pakinggan ng tao yan, Carmina.
Pero hindi ba magiging mas klaro yung solusyon ni former Senator Marcos kapag ito po ay katabi ng iba pang mga solusyon, ng ibang mga contender?
That is why tomorrow, Carmina, I even invite you to watch that live SM&I debate wherein I think all of them, eight candidates, have confirmed their appearance and their joining. So I even invite you to go and watch that live SM&I debate.
Conflict of schedule, Attorney Vic, was the reason given why you decided to skip the CNN debates and opted to appear at the SM&I sponsored one tomorrow. So it's either there's poor management of scheduling or you really just choose friendly ones. Which one is it?
Just the very, very tight schedule, Carmina. And we will be on the road by the 24, 25, 26, 27, and 28th. And hindi naman namin pwedeng i-disappoint muli yung aming mga supporters na nagplano na as early as January. And we have to reschedule it kasi nga nagkaroon kami lahat ng COVID. So yun lang yan. At medyo I caution you na not to read too much between the lines because there is nothing to read.
But here's something that is very clear when you read it. You said, I think it was a couple of weeks back, when you said that you will continue to shun and skip debates. This is not verbatim because you don't want former Senator Marcos to be pit against other candidates. And now you're engaging in the SM&I debate. So how do you reconcile both statements, Attorney Rodriguez?
Because I think SM&I format have responded to our call for an increase in the bandwidth on real issues. Rather than negativity or political mudslinging, there we will be given a chance to talk about foreign policy, pandemic response, counterinsurgency, agriculture, food security, and environment. That's all what we have been calling for all this time, an increase the bandwidth on real issues, Carmina.
But I saw the KBP debates. And I doubt that CNN will also engage in mudslinging.
That is your opinion, Carmina. And I'm not going to debate with you on this. You are entitled to your opinion. And I respect it, Carmina. I will even defend your right to express your opinion, Carmina.
Attorney Vic, did you see where you presented the format that CNN will have in their debate?
Doon naman magkakaroon talaga ng conflict sa aming schedule. And I have made it clear, schedule permitting, and after the format permitting, we will attend the invitations for debates like this. Again, schedule and format permitting. We have suffered, Carmina, long enough. We have suffered long enough from that loss of solidarity. And we have been calling for everyone to elevate the political discourse, increase the bandwidth on real issues, and we will engage.
I want to get your opinion on the circles of discernment that the Catholic Church is urging their followers to join prior to the May 9 elections. Also, we have heard CBCP President Bishop David saying that to be neutral is a sin and that to be neutral now is to side with evil. What are your thoughts regarding that, Attorney Rodriguez, and how might this affect your campaign in the run-up to the May 9 elections?
The people have spoken, Carmina, and they will continue to stand for what they believe is their freedom of choice. And this early, they have made and have shown their preference on who to support this coming 2022 election. And the good bishop, kagaya na sinabi ko sa iyo, he's entitled to his own opinion and maaaring magkasalungat ang aming paniniwala, subalit wala siyang maririnig sa amin at ipagtatanggol namin yung karapatan niya magpahayag ng kanyang saloobin at personal na opinion kagaya mo.
Kagaya po ng karapatan na yan or kasama sa karapatan na yan ang separation of the church and the state, do you think by issuing those statements that Bishop David is sort of influencing, meddling with the affairs of the state?
Well, he is mature enough and he is occupying a lofty position, so I would submit to his discretion and he knows what he's doing.
Attorney Rodriguez, when you talk about SMNI, you cannot not talk about Pastor Apollo Quiboloy's predicament as we speak. So how do you campaign around that? That here you have the head of the SMNI, an endorser of the BBM Sara Duterte Carpio tandem, was also a fugitive now in the United States, was wanted for sex trafficking charges, among others. How do you campaign around that?
Well, these are all allegations still, and we'll just let hayaan natin gumulong ang hustisya, Carmina, at pagtanggol niya yung kanyang sarili. At hindi naman din kami, at hindi rin na po ang tamang tao at abogado na magsalita on his behalf. I'm pretty sure he will have his own legal team, and he will be given his day in court, his chance to answer all these allegations.
Do you think that he's hurting your campaign?
Well, I don't see any relation between our campaign and the allegation being hurled against him.
As a final question, Attorney Vic, you know, some are of the opinion, and experts that have interviewed have already said this, that it is really part of your strategy, part of your plan, not to engage, because your numbers are already up there. And to engage in challenging debates and interviews will only pull your numbers down. Is that your strategy? Is that your plan?
I mean, the strategy, even before our numbers reach this high, is not to engage in negativity, not to engage in negative campaigning, not to engage in political mudslinging. That is our strategy.
Let me ask you, though, Attorney Rodriguez, why do you equate challenging interviews and debates with negativity? It doesn't make sense.
We have never equated challenging interviews and debates with negativity. In fact, I will repeat, we have submitted to that very challenging interview, DZBB, GMA7. We have submitted to that more than 2 hours of live panel interview, which are equally challenging, if not more challenging, presented by DZRH. We have submitted to that very challenging one-on-one interview with Boyabunda. So I do not understand what you're trying to imply, that we're evading or trying to skip challenging interviews or debates.
There are 3 more debates coming up, COMELEC-sponsored ones. I've spoken to Director James Jimenez about this. You have not given any answer regarding the invitation or if the invitation has been sent already. But are you going to appear in these COMELEC-sponsored debates?
Again, Carmina, schedule permitting, and let me take a look at the format. If it is meant to let the candidates present their visions, their platform, their manner of governance, and present their proposed solution, we might attend. We might attend.
All right, but you know, if it's still a long ways to go, and you know, you have your calendar before you, don't you think it's that important? Don't you think this should take precedence over the other items that have been penciled into the calendar?
Our schedules are pretty full until middle of April, Carmina. But again, if we can adjust to it and the format will be is meant, if the format is designed in such a way that it will be given the candidates chance to present their platform, their governance, and their proposed solution, we might take and agree on appearing on those proposed scheduled debates.
Attorney Vic Rodriguez, they are spokesperson of Ferdinand Marcos Jr., who's running for president. Thank you so much for joining us today. Appreciate it. Take care and keep safe.
Thank you, Carmina, and good afternoon.